So what's popping, y'all? It's your boy Flex Luthor. Okay, so I'm sure by now you've heard of what's going on with Derrick Jaxn. If you haven't heard, dude was caught cheating on his wife. Now you may be thinking, all right, so men cheat on women every day, B. All right, and usually I nod in agreement, but today it's a little different. See, Derrick Jaxn has made a career pandering to women by talking down on men and basically spreading a ladies, it's not your fault you're single, these men are no good type of message. While most of us are having a hearty laugh about the irony of Derrick Jaxn's current predicament, in this video, I'm gonna be talking about how it's not just the cheating that makes him look bad right now, but that apology video he dropped made things 10 times worse. So before we jump into this, do me a solid and go ahead and smash that like button and subscribe to the channel to see more videos like this. So it's no secret that sometimes social media personalities, celebrities, corporations, even governments screw up from a public relations perspective. And I mean screw up big. I mean, remember Monica Lewinsky? You know, you got the CEO of Papa John's being labeled a racist, all the way to Jada Pinkett's entanglement. When these things happen, the damage control employed can make or break the person or organization's public image. Which brings me to Derrick Jaxn. Now, I could only assume that apology video was the undertaking of him or his team attempting to do damage control behind him getting exposed for having an affair. Now, in all honesty, the details of the affair really don't matter, so I won't be discussing them. So to do damage control, you have to acknowledge that damage has occurred and attempt to fix it. Now, this is not to be confused with being unpopular or controversial. See, Donald Trump was controversial, but never really found himself in a position where he had to do serious damage control because his audience just loved everything he did. They love him to this day. So Derrick Jaxn, on the other hand, has built himself up as a relationship expert that women flock to by the millions. Having him be a cheater is critical hit type of damage. So I can understand why controlling that damage can be seen as a needed step to take. But like the Jada situation, sometimes damage control turns out to be the thing that causes the most damage. Which brings us to this apology video. To be honest with you, fam, you don't even really have to watch that shit to see the damage control is just causing more damage. You can gather all of that from just the thumbnail. I mean, close your eyes and pick any random point in this video and you can still see it. What damage, you ask? Good question. All right, so check it. First off, his wife looks, in the words of Charles Barkley, terrible. I mean, she's wearing what at first glance looks to be a bonnet, but is really like some hideous ass looking koofy. She has on no bra and looks all around busted. I mean, it's really bad. Now, I'm not a follower of Derrick Jaxn, but I've seen many of his videos over the years, and I don't recall ever seeing his wife. And I'm fairly certain that's by design. So why have her look like that in the video that's gonna serve as many people's first time seeing her? And consider, we only see her after he cheated on her and embarrassed a woman that millions of other women have probably envied for years, and he chooses to present her like that? I mean, if she wasn't up for it, he probably should have just waited to make the video or just not done an apology video altogether. I mean, with the understanding that his main demographic is women, many of which have turned to him because they have dealt with getting cheated on in the past and feel like he's an expert. I mean, is that the message you really want to send to them? His wife looked uncomfortable, like she didn't want to do this. The same way Will Smith looked hella uncomfortable last year. And like Jada, Derrick looked like he wasn't really remorseful. He looked like he was already over it and just wanted to get past this quickly. I think too many women can relate to the despair that they saw in the wife's face for them to ever accept that bullshit apology video. All right, so what should he have done? So I think there are three things Derrick Jaxn could have done to make this apology video way better and make it go over better with his audience. First off, everything I'm about to suggest is under the assumption that the goal is to do damage control, which in this context means retaining as much of his audience and credibility as possible. Now, while being the preacher who sleeps with a church member is bad, it's not something that hasn't been done before. So there are ways around it. First off, I like the idea of having your wife in the video to show a united front, but you can't have her looking like she just woke up from her afternoon nap. I know his wife must be a pretty woman, but he certainly didn't make her look like that in the video. If Derrick Jaxn is a man of means, he needs to have his wife looking like she is married to a man of means. By having her come on camera like that, he's communicating that she's broken, lost, and trapped in a terrible situation. You don't gotta take my word for it. Just scroll through the comments on that apology video and see for yourself. Secondly, the female audience needs to be reassured that there are consequences to those actions, especially since that's something he preaches all the time. During her time speaking, the wife mentions that they had separated and got back together. This does very little for an audience that just found out that they were having problems 2 days ago. They want to see blood, if you will. I think with her looking good and saying that they are going to be currently separating due to this situation that's happening right now is a much more effective way in making the audience feel like Derrick is getting his comeuppance. I mean, she could announce that they're going to use this separation time to start fresh and get to know one another all over, all that jazz. Mind you, even if it's not true, even if they have no intention on separating, it's still the wise thing to do to appease the female audience who wants to see consequences. And lastly, Derrick should have announced that his message is going to be shifting from a once hella judgy perspective to a I'm not where I need to be, but I'm working on it type of message. The truth is, playing the role of the perfect guy only works for those who are perfect with their family life, like Barack Obama or some shit. Derrick can say he's not perfect all he wants, but when he says stuff like this...
But let me say this, I have no sympathy for a man who finds it to be difficult to be faithful after being in a promiscuous lifestyle, and neither should you.
He's making himself seem like he has this whole relationship game figured out and he's not on some fuckboy shit. I mean, he's literally saying what he has no sympathy for and telling you that you should feel the exact same way. And to be truthful, he's lost all credibility to even speak like that. But if he were to employ more empathy in his message when talking about men, it would be all to the good. Focusing his message on his journey of learning and getting better emotionally will help him regain his credibility over time. But alas, that is not what we got. No, sir. We got a sloppy, not well thought out apology video with a wife who kind of looks like she's beyond done with the whole situation. Now, I know many of us dudes have found Derrick Jaxn to be the king of pandering for years, and we're just so delighted at this situation. We smiling from ear to ear. All right, so let me just say, I don't think... I'm just playing. Keep on smiling, bruh. The king of pandering just took that L and he has to hold it. Yeah, and don't listen to those women who leave comments like, oh, I always knew he was shady. Psh, yeah, whatever. Everybody knew, huh? Well, for people who knew, y'all sure was giving him money and making sure he got paid, huh? But anyway, tell me what you think in the comments. Do you see what I'm saying about the apology video? Or do you have any more suggestions on better ways he could have handled it? Till next time, peace.